Hi viewers, we will cover the wide range of topics in circuit analysis in this series of videos. Today we will start with the basics of DC circuits. Normally the DC circuit elements are classified into two types. One is passive elements, another one is the active elements. Let's see the passive elements. So passive elements means it only receives energy which it can dissipate or stores energy. The example of these passive elements are resistor, inductor, capacitor. And next DC circuit element is active elements. So active elements means it can generate or amplifies energy. The example of these active elements are voltage, current, transistor, diodes. So this diagram shows the best example of this DC circuit element. So here active elements means battery, so it generates the energy. And then next passive elements means this bulb, it receives the energy. So here active elements, it generates the energy. Passive elements means it pass or receives the energy from the active elements. And next one is the passive element. So we know that passive elements are resistor, inductor, capacitor. So let's see the resistor. So resistor means it opposes the flow of current through it, and then it is denoted by R. The unit of this resistor is ohm. So this is the symbol of the resistor. Normally this resistor is directly proportional to L divided by A. So in order to remove this proportionality, we can write this as R equal to rho L divided by A. So remove this proportionality, we can add this rho. So here rho is the resistivity of the material, and then L is the length of the conductor, and then A is the area of conductor or resistance of conductor. And next one is the capacitor. Capacitor, it stores electrical energy in an electric field, and it can be denoted as C. The unit of this capacitor is farads. So here this is the symbol of the capacitor. So this line represents positive, and then this one is the negative. So we can also draw the capacitor like this. So here this line represents the positive, and the curved line represents the negative. Next one is the inductor. Inductor means it stores the applied electrical energy in the form of electromagnetic field. It is denoted by capital L. The unit of inductor is Henry. This is the symbol of the inductor. Next one is the active element. So active elements also called as energy sources. So we know that active elements are voltage, current. So let's see the voltage source. So voltage source, when current leaves from the positive terminal of the voltage source, energy is being supplied to the circuit. That is, in voltage, the current flows from this positive terminal to this negative terminal. And then this line represents the positive, and then short line represents the negative. Also, we can draw the voltage as this one, positive and then negative. This is the symbol of the voltage. And then it is denoted by V, and the unit of this voltage is volts, which is represented as V. Next one is the current source. So current source means flow of electric charge. That is, a current source is controlling the flow of charge in a circuit. It is denoted by capital I. Then the unit of the current is ampere, capital A. So this is the symbol of the current source. This arrow represents the symbol of the current source. Next one is the source transformation. So source transformations, voltage source to current source conversion. So first let's see the voltage source to current source conversion. Normally the voltage is series with the resistance. Always the voltage is series with the resistance. So how we can convert this voltage into current means using Ohm's law. So Ohm's law, V equal to I into R. So from that we can write I equal to V divided by R. Our main aim is to calculate the current. So I equal to V by R. So we know the value of V, and then we know the value of R, means we can easily calculate the current. I equal to V by R. And then next we have to convert this voltage into current means we have to draw the current source parallel with the resistance. Voltage is series with the resistance, and then current is parallel with the resistance. So this resistance we have to draw it as parallel to the current source. This is the voltage source to current source conversion. Next one is the current source to voltage source conversion. So we know that current is parallel with the resistance. So but in this circuit we need voltage. So we know that V equal to I into R. So we know the I value and then R value, means we can easily calculate the value V. V equal to I into R. So here we know that voltage is always series with the resistor. So just we have to redraw the resistor, this parallel resistor, here in this voltage series with this voltage source. So here this voltage is series with the resistor. This is the current source to voltage conversion. So keep it in mind, the voltage is series with the resistor, the current is parallel with the resistance. Next is the Ohm's law. So Ohm's law, at constant temperature, the current flowing through a conductor will be directly proportional to the applied voltage across the two ends of the conductor. That is V proportional to I. V directly proportional to I. In order to remove this proportionality, we can add this R. This is the very important law, Ohm's law. V equal to IR, where R is the resistance of conductor. And then we know that R equal to rho L divided by A. So consider the resistor, current flowing through this resistor is I. How we can calculate the voltage, means using Ohm's law. So V equal to I into R. Using this we can calculate the voltage drop across this resistor. Then limitations of Ohm's law. So limitations of Ohm's law, first one, it is not applicable to the nonlinear devices such as diode, voltage regulator, etc. The next one is that it is not suitable for devices where the temperature is varying. So with the help of the Ohm's law, we can calculate the power. P equal to V into I. P equal to I square R. P equal to V square divided by R. The unit of power is watts, and the energy is calculated E, which is equal to power into time. So just in this equation, substitute the power value. So V into I into T, and then I square R into T, then V square by R into T. The unit of energy is watts R. Next one is the series circuit and voltage division. So here consider three resistors R1, R2, R3 are connected in series, and then here the voltages are different. Consider R1, R2, R3 resistor, the voltage drop across these resistors are different, but the current flowing through this circuit will be same. That is, the voltage, if three resistors are connected in series, means the voltages are different. That is V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. But the current flowing through the resistance is same. That is I. So consider the serial light. In this serial light, the current flowing through the serial light is same. For example, if one bulb is broken, means the entire series light will be blocked. There is no light will glow. That is, this is based on the series circuit and voltage division concept. So here, because in serial light, series means the current is same. So, and then voltage is different. Next, the current through the each resistance is R equivalent. So R equivalent, which is equal to three resistors are connected in series, means sum of the individual resistor, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Next one is the voltage across a given resistor. So how we can, using this voltage division, how we can calculate the voltage drop across given resistor using voltage division rule, which is equal to applied voltage into value of the branch resistance divided by total loop resistance. So how we can calculate voltage drop across this R1, means if you know the total voltage, we can use this voltage division rule. So here we have to calculate voltage drop across this R1. So V1, which is equal to total voltage V into particular resistor. So we have to calculate the voltage drop across this R1, means R1 divided by sum of the resistor. The three resistors are R1, R2, R3, sum of the resistors. This is the voltage division rule. That is, voltage division rule is applied voltage into value of the branch resistance divided by total loop resistance. Suppose we have to calculate the voltage drop across this R2, means total voltage V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Next one is the parallel circuit. So parallel circuit and current division rule. So here in this parallel circuit, this is opposite to the series circuit. Here voltages are same but the currents are different. So voltage is same but the currents are different. So this is the parallel circuit. The best example of this parallel circuit in our house wiring. So in our house wiring, we are using the parallel circuit connection. So let us consider one example. If one bulb is broken, damage means the another bulb will glow. This broken bulb does not affect the another circuit connection. Then in this parallel circuit, we have to consider two resistors and then three resistors. So how we can consider means, so this is the two resistor connection example. So how we can calculate the R equivalent for this two resistor means R equivalent, which is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the formula to calculate R equivalent. And then current division rule. So current division rule for two resistors. So consider these two resistors are connected in parallel. Parallel means we have to take the formula of these two. So here how we can calculate R equivalent means R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And the current division rule, particular current we have to calculate means incoming current into opposite branch resistance divided by total loop resistance. This is only applicable for two resistors all connected in parallel. So I1, if you want to calculate current flow through this R1 resistor means total current I into opposite resistance R2 divided by sum of the resistance. And next one is the three resistors. Suppose three resistors are connected in parallel. Parallel means the equivalent resistance 1 by R equivalent, which is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is the R equivalent equation. And then using current division, how we can calculate the current flow through this R1 resistor means total current into 1 divided by R1, that is particular resistance divided by reciprocal of each sum of each resistors. Okay, so here this is the basic formula. So this is only applicable for two resistors, and then these two equations is applicable for the three resistors all connected in parallel. Next one is the inductor. So inductors are connected in series means the L equivalent we can calculate using this formula. L equivalent, which is equal to L1 plus L2. And then inductors are connected in parallel means we can calculate L equivalent, which is equal to L1 L2 divided by L1 plus L2. Next one is the capacitor. So capacitors in series. Series means C equivalent, which is equal to C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. This is opposite to the inductor. And then in capacitors in parallel means C equivalent, which is equal to C1 plus C2. Next one is the Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's current law. Kirchhoff's current law is sum of incoming current, which is equal to sum of outgoing current. Let us consider this diagram. Here incoming current is I1, and then here incoming current is I3. So incoming current I1 plus I3, which is equal to the outgoing currents. Outgoing currents are I2, I4, I5. So I1 plus I3, which is equal to outgoing currents are I2 plus I4 plus I5. This is the Kirchhoff's current law. Next one is the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Sum of potential drops, which is equal to the potential rises. So potential drops, which is equal to potential rises. So potential rises means the supply voltage. So supply voltages are in this diagram E1 and E2. So here we can write it as E1 plus E2, which is equal to potential drop. So we know that each resistor is having some voltage drop. So here in this is the series circuit. So we know that series means the currents are same. So current is same means, so the total current is considered as I. So Ohm's law we can write it as V equal to I into R. Here voltage drop across this R1 is IR1. Voltage drop across this R2 is I into R2. So we can write the equation as IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3 plus IR4. That is potential drop, sum of potential drop, which is equal to, this is the sum of potential drops, which is equal to sum of potential rises E1 plus E2. Next, solved problems. So here in the circuit shown below, find the equivalent resistor. So in this, we have to calculate the equivalent resistance. So equivalent resistance, we should know parallel and series connection. So first consider these two resistors. So we have to check whether these two resistors are connected in parallel or series. So how we can check this one means, so here this R4 and R5 is connected in same point, that is this point. Okay, and then the another one end is also same point. R4 and R5, both the ends are connected in same point. That is, this resistors is having two common point, means it is parallel. Okay, so these two resistors is having two common points, so it is parallel. So we know the parallel operation of two resistors, that is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So 60 into 40 divided by 60 plus 40, which is equal to 24 ohm. Next, we have to redraw this circuit like this. So these two parallel is considered as one, the value is 24 ohm. Next, we have to check these two resistor whether it is connected in series or parallel. So here this two end is connected in one common point, and then another one is meet this another point. Here this 18 ohm is also connected in another point. So these two resistors is having only one common point, mean it is connected in series. Here two common point means it is connected in parallel. So these two resistors are connected in series. So series means just we have to add the resistor. That is 82 plus 18, which is equal to 100. This is also connected in series. 24 plus 76, which is equal to 100. So here then next we have to redraw the circuit. So we can convert this R23 and then R456 are 100. So next we have to check these two resistors are connected in parallel. Yes, because it is having two common points. So this is connected in parallel. So we know the relation. Parallel means R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. That is, answer is 50 ohm. Next also we have to redraw the circuit. So these two is combined into one resistor. Next, these two are connected in series because it is having only one common point. Just we have to add the resistor. So the answer is R equivalent, which is equal to 150 ohm. Next problem, determine the power delivered by the current source in the figure. So in this, we have to find the power. So before we have to calculate the, we don't know the total current. So we don't know the total current means we have to calculate the first we have to calculate the total current, and then in the problem they given the current flowing through this 2 ohm resistor is 4 ampere. So if you know that, if you want to calculate the total current and then they given one current point, means we can apply the current division rule. So we know that current division rule means incoming current into opposite branch resistance divided by total loop resistance. So using this formula we can calculate the total current. So how we can calculate means, first we have to consider the current flowing through this 2 ohm resistor. So current, we know the current value, that is 4, which is equal to total current, we don't know, that is I into opposite resistance. So this resistor opposite resistance means this 4 ohm, 4 ohm divided by sum of the resistance, 4 plus 2. No need to consider this 5 because we have to consider only this parallel connection, parallel. No need to consider the total this resistance. No need to consider this 5 ohm resistance. We have to consider only this 2 because we have to calculate this 4 ohm current flowing through this 2 ohm resistor. So we have to consider these two. Opposite resistance 4 divided by sum of the resistance 4 plus 2. Then I value, we found the value was I equal to 6 ampere. But then the problem they asked, power delivered by the current source. Powers we have to calculate. Power P which is equal to I square into R. So we don't know the R value, total R equivalent we have to calculate. So these two are connected in parallel. So parallel means R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Then these two are connected in series. So just add the value. So R equal to parallel connection first and then add the series connection. So we found the value of R. Next P which is equal to, we know that I square into R. We found the value I which is equal to 6. So 6 square. R value which is equal to 6.333 which is equal to 228 watts. So this is the power of this circuit, 228, the unit of power is watts. Next problem, find the current I in figure below. So here, so this is the circuit. So in this circuit we know that current is parallel with the resistor. And then first we have to convert this current into voltage by source transformation. So V equal to I into R. We know the I value and then R value. So I into 5 into 12 which is equal to 60 volt. And then the arrow is downward, means the positive is in the downside. Next here, consider this current and resistor V equal to I into R. The arrow is upward side. So the voltage symbol positive sign in the upside. And then we know that always series, the voltage is series with the resistor. Just we have to redraw the circuit here. This resistor, parallel resistor, if you convert this current into voltage, means the parallel resistor, it should be in the series with the voltage. Here also the same. And then this is the one loop. So here this is the one loop and then voltage source we are having. So we can easily find using the Kirchhoff's voltage law. And then Kirchhoff's voltage law, here we are having two supply voltages. So in this circuit, we have to consider the highest voltage value, that is 750 volt. And then we know that the current always pass through the positive terminal to this negative terminal. So we can choose this 750 volt. This is the highest voltage. The current flow direction is this direction because positive to negative flow direction. And then next we have to apply this 750. We know that each resistor is having some voltage drop. So V equal to I into R. The total current flowing through this circuit is I because this is the series connection. So here 750 minus 30I minus 88I minus 12I. Then here one point, this arrow meets this negative means we should put plus sign. Okay. So 750 minus 30I minus 8I minus 12I plus 60 which is equal to 0. Why I am putting here minus means because each resistor is having some voltage drop. So minus. So here why I am putting this positive means this arrow is current is flowing from this direction. Arrow enters this minus means plus. And then here the arrow enters this minus means plus. So it is equal to 0. So from this we can easily calculate the I current value. And next problem, calculate the current drawn from the battery in the given network. So this is the diagram. So here in this type of problem, just we have to redraw the circuit using Wheatstone bridge circuit. So in this, just this is the diagonal resistor and the next remaining resistor. So this is the circuit we have redraw. And the next, first we have to check whether this is balanced or unbalanced. So how we can check this one means using this relation. R1 divided by R5 which is equal to R4 divided by R3. That is this R1 divided by R5 which is equal to R4 divided by R3. So we know the value 1 by 2 which is equal to 2 by 4. The both the values are equal. So this is balanced. In most of the problem they asked they won't give this R3 value. We have to calculate the R3 value. This type of circuit, we have to calculate the R3 value means using this relation. This relations we can easily find the R3 value. So here we have to calculate the current. Current we have to calculate. So R equivalent, first we know the voltage value and then we have to calculate the R equivalent value. So this value will be 0 because this is the balanced circuit. So no need to consider this one. And then consider these two resistors. These two resistors are connected in series. So just we have to add, and then here also series add. After that, these two resistors are connected in parallel. So here 1 plus 2 parallel 2 plus 4. So R equivalent value is 2 ohm. Then we know the relation I equal to V by R. We know the value in the given circuit. They given the value voltage is V, and then R we found the value 2. So the answer is 2 ampere. And next one, when a low resistance is connected in parallel with a high resistance, the combined resistance always less than the low resistance. Let's see the proof. Consider the low resistance value as 0.5 and the high resistance value as 5 ohm. So we know the relations of parallel connection. So this is parallel. So in the question they given, both the resistors are connected in parallel. So parallel means we know the relation, that is R equivalent, which is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, which is equal to, we got the value as 0.45 ohm. This value is less than the smallest value of the resistor. So the answer is always less than the low resistance. And next problem, resistance of a wire is R ohm. The wire is stretched to double its length. Then its resistance in ohm is, answer, 4R. So let's see the proof. We know that R equal to rho L divided by A. So here the length is double. Length is double means 2 into L. If the length is double means the area is quadruple, that is half A divided by 2. Then if we substitute the value here, we will get 4 into rho L divided by A. So rho L divided by A is the resistor R. So we can write it as 4 into R. Next problem, 3 capacitors are connected in series. So we know the relation 1 by C equivalent equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So this is the 1 by C equivalent value. So we have to calculate the C equivalent. Just reciprocal, 3 divided by 2, the answer is 1.5. All the capacitor is having microfarad, microfarad. So the answer is 1.5 microfarad. Next problem, 2 incandescent light bulbs, 40 watts and 60 watts ratings are connected in series across the mains. The answer is 40 watt bulb glows brighter. So normally consider our house wiring. We know that this is the parallel. So in parallel, in our house 100 watts bulb is glows better than the 60 watt bulb. So this is the parallel connection. Highest watt power will glows brighter. But here in the problem, they asked series. So this is parallel. Parallel is our house wiring. And then series means just opposite. Lower rated power will glows brighter. So answer is 40 watt bulb glows brighter. Next problem. So they given two circuits, and then both the circuit is having same current. In the problem, they given both the circuit is having same current. We have to calculate the R0. So how we can calculate means, first consider the figure 1. First I equal to Ohm's law, I equal to V divided by R. So V, and then R we are having 3 parallel resistors. So 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So I equal to V divided by R. So 1 by R already we are having 7 by 32 R. Just we have to substitute here. So we found the value of I for the first figure. Next second figure we have to calculate. So I equal to V by R. In this 3 are connected in parallel. After that R0 is connected in series. So first let us see these 3 resistors consider as R1. So R equivalent equal to R1 plus R0. So R equivalent 1 by R equivalent, which is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So here R1 we have to calculate. So R1 which is equal to just reciprocal of this one. Next R equivalent which is equal to sum of the 2 resistors. So next we have to calculate the I. I equal to V by R. Just substitute the value. Now we are having 2 current. Both the currents are equal. So just equate the 2 currents, and then from that we can easily calculate the R0 value. Next problem. In the figure, find the value of the resistance R. So here, suppose in this problem they given the total current means, easily we can find the resistor value by using current division rule. But here in this we know the voltage, total voltage means we have to apply the KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. So for that, consider here this is one node, that is A. The voltage is here in this node is VA. And then these two are connected in parallel, means we know that parallel connection, the voltages are same. So just we have to apply KCL. So KCL means Kirchhoff's current law, I equal to V by R. So consider this node here, 100 minus VA divided by 10, that is V by R. 100 minus VA divided by 10, which is equal to Kirchhoff's current law, incoming current, which is equal to outgoing current. This is the total current flowing through this, and then this will be leaving current. So here, which is equal to V by R, this is the VA, and then minus this value will be 0. Always this is the ground connection, so there is no node, this is the ground, 0. So we can write it as VA by 10 plus this current flowing through this R, they given in the problem 2. So VA divided by 10 plus 2. From this we can easily calculate the VA value is 41. So in the problem they asked find the resistance value. So here R equal to V by I, they given the total voltage is V by I, which is equal to V value was 40 volt, and then I value R equal to V by I, 40 divided by I value in the resistor is having the current is 2, 40 divided by 2, which is equal to 20 ohm. So this is the answer of this resistance value, 20 ohm. Okay, next video I will show how to use the scientific calculator for solving matrix equations and complex calculations. To get the notifications of my next video, please subscribe and click on the bell icon. Thank you.